breaking news out of Washington. Special Counsel Robert Mueller has concluded his investigation and delivered his final report to U.S. Attorney General William Barr.
On April 18, 2019, the Justice Department released the redacted Mueller report to the public. The 448-page document details a story that has captured America's attention.
From Russian plots to interfere with our election to constitutional questions of executive power, the Mueller report is potentially one of the most important and consequential documents of our time.
But there's a problem. Very few people have actually read it.
2 years ago, the acting attorney general asked me to serve as special counsel, and he created the special counsel's office. It is important that the office's written work speak for itself. It contains our findings and analysis and the reasons for the decisions, and the report is my testimony.
The charges say it was the work of 12 officers of Russian military intelligence.
The report did not clear the president of obstruction of justice, who relentlessly sought to use top White House staffers to, quote, curtail the investigation.
That clearly stated that the Russian government was in fact behind the interference operations that we were seeing at the time.
If you endeavor to obstruct justice but fail, it's still a crime. If you obstruct justice but it turns out there's no underlying crime, it's still a crime.
There was no collusion with Russia. The most ridiculous thing I've ever heard.
The Mueller report outlines disturbing evidence that President Trump engaged in obstruction of justice and other misconduct.
They made a decision that there was no obstruction, so that makes it a complete and total exoneration. I don't know any other way to look at it.
There is still so much confusion about the report, what it says, who it implicates, and what it means for our country. I'm Benjamin Wittes.
And I'm Susan Hennessy. At Lawfare, we are distilling the report into a multi-part audio narrative series, telling you the story of what's in this document, the story Robert Mueller wants you to understand.
And I will close by reiterating the central allegation of our indictments, that there were multiple systematic efforts to interfere in our election. And that allegation deserves the attention of every American.
To learn more, subscribe to The Report, wherever you get your podcasts.